But like, I think if I look at what the lineage of it and what it means to me, I think R&B is probably the closest fit, you know, in terms of an established genre. Or pop music, you know, I'm informed by pop music, always have been. So, you know, I always tried to. I always wanted to make a record that, you know, a lot of people would be able to hear, and that would reflect my interest, you know, my influence, or that felt like it came from a space, you know, from inside me, and that things were working in sync with lyrics and music, and that had its own identity. And I guess I probably quite. You know, I don't deliberately say, oh, I'm going to have a little bit of this and a little bit of that, but I think, you know, that's the way I've always liked working, I've always liked writing things like that. I just always listen to a lot of different music. And that's just how it came out, really. I think, the main guiding principles I wanted to be a calming record, and I wanted it to just have 10 or 11 of my best songs. But yeah, I think you know, Burial was. I mean, one of the he didn't produce it because he didn't. You know, it was kind of me from start to finish. But he did. He definitely. He didn't want to call it that he produced it either. Because he hadn't been in. You know, when he produces, he's got total control over what he's doing, and that wasn't the case. You know, he contributed contributed parts, and he really sent me along my way.
So you are the producer then?
With
influences from.
Yes, absolutely. So he comes from, you know, the kind of music that he draws from, underground dance, UK dance music.
Yeah.
It's not about being a personality.
No. It's about being music.
It's just about making music, you know.
Yeah.
And he's certain that, but you know, that magical feeling of hearing a tune and not knowing what it is. Too deep to know where you're going, hoping time can be frozen, and you'll end up where you. There's some amazing movements going on.
Would you consider that you have a little bit of the same style?
Yeah, I think I'd probably draw from some of the same influences.
Mm-hmm. While we have oceans, rivers that still run the slide, reasons to dance in the moment, I'll hold on to your time. And let your heart go where the wind takes it, a pure light, the rain drops of time, and follow the path that it takes you.
But I think, yeah, most of the things that I listen to and I'm finding interesting are, you know, the blending different things. I think pure genre doesn't really seem to exist anymore.
Yeah.
You know, the sooner we can just get on, agree with that and get on with it, the better.
Listen to your lyrics, I feel that you're a very thoughtful person, are you?
Yeah, I'm quite. Probably a bit too much. I think, well, with my first record, you know, those songs are about, they're just about that time in my life, really. You know, I think the only time I feel moved to write is if I feel moved by something, by a sensation or a situation, or confused about my reaction to something, or by something. As a way to externalize my internal things. Not necessarily understand them, but just extend them. So it's kind of like a note for yourself. And I think if you have knowledge, then it's worth sharing. It's not the same thing that everyone else looks at the world. It's just a viewpoint. There's people that write amazing storytelling songs or put themselves in that kind of characters. That's not something I try not to make it just all about, stops hurting, you know, it's definitely about me, even though I know I deserve the subject matter is not all about me, it's about relating to me. I think anxiety, stress, you can't eradicate them, but if I do as much as I can to be on the level.
I thought it was so interesting how you found the name Mirrorwriting. Could you?
There's a few reasons, really. I mean, I really like this. I like the way it looked, like the way it sounded. Mm. But you know, the record, again, like you say, it's about me. and it's about that, I guess taking note of that. A lot of the songs are written from a viewpoint of trying to step outside myself and look at myself. And that's the feeling I get when I listen to or experience art or film or anything that moves me.
Yeah.
Synthesize, and it ain't something you can buy.